In this video, we are going to write isotopic symbol for isotopes. Isotopic symbol is also known as isotope notation or nuclear notation. Basically, it contains three types of information: the symbol of the element, the atomic mass, and the atomic number. We can write it out this way, where X is the chemical symbol, A is the atomic mass and we write it at the top left, and Z is the atomic number and we write it on the bottom left. Atomic mass is the larger number that's in decimal place, and atomic number is the smaller whole number. This information, you can find them in the periodic table. In case you need a recap on what's an isotope, it's basically one element having different variants. They all have the same number of protons, but they have different number of neutrons. And because of that, they have the same atomic number, but different atomic mass. Just a quick recap, atomic number represents the number of protons, whereas atomic mass is the sum of number of protons and number of neutrons. And that's why isotopes have the same atomic number, but different atomic mass. It's because of the difference in number of neutrons. So let's take fluorine, for example. It has a total of 17 isotopes. They range from fluorine 14 all the way to fluorine 31. From these 17 isotopes, the most stable and abundantly found isotope is fluorine 19. Let's start with the most stable fluorine isotope, which is fluorine 19. So 19 right here represents the atomic mass for this specific isotope. And if we look up the information for fluorine, this is what we can find. 9 is the atomic number. That's the small whole number. F is the chemical symbol. So these are the three information that we need to plug into the isotopic symbol. And this is what we get. The important point to note is the atomic mass of the isotopic symbol must be written in whole number, since this represents the mass of a specific isotope. So meaning to say, you should write 19 for fluorine 19's atomic mass, not 18.998, which is the atomic mass you can find in the periodic table, because that mass represents the mass of the other isotopes that are present for fluorine. If we're writing the isotopic symbol for fluorine 31, it will be this. We simply change out the atomic mass. The chemical symbol and the atomic number stays the same. Now, let's do this the other way around. What if we get an isotopic symbol and we're asked to find the following: atomic number. Well, that's written on the bottom left, right? So that means that 16. Atomic mass, well, that's the number that is written on the top left corner, so that means it's 34. Number of proton, that's the same as the atomic number, so that means it's also 16. The number of electrons in an atom is the same as the number of proton, which is also the same as atomic number, so that's 16 as well. Number of neutrons. Remember that atomic mass is the number of proton plus number of neutron. Well, if you plug in the information, you can solve for number of neutron, and that's 18. To recap, we write the chemical symbol on the right and the atomic mass on the top left, and followed by the atomic number on the bottom left. Atomic mass is the larger number that is found in the periodic table, or it can be given by the question. Keep in mind that that's the total number of protons and neutrons. And also, this number must be written in whole number for isotopic symbol. Whereas the atomic number, that's the smaller whole number found in the periodic table. That is also the number of protons. With that, we're done with isotopic symbol. Hope the video helped you out somehow. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.